Not only is the Great Barrier Reef big, it also has diverse marine life and habitats. For 35 years, our long-term monitoring program has been dedicated to measuring its coral reefs. We can't survey all the individual reefs on the Great Barrier Reef, but we can measure its health by taking a representative sample. Reefs differ between the coastline and the continental shelf. Reefs close to the coast thrive in more turbid waters, whereas those further offshore are better adapted to clearer water. Therefore, we survey reefs close to the coast, further offshore and at the edge of the continental shelf, along the entire length of the Great Barrier Reef, because the habitats and environmental influences also vary from north to south. We survey reefs in various bioregions, which are areas that have similar plants and animals. And finally, we survey reefs dependent on management zones, such as reefs that are open or closed to fishing. To compare the data consistently, all our surveys are located on the reef slope of every reef. This is typically the most diverse area and also the most practical. Together, these components capture representative areas of the entire reef. We've been surveying the same sites at the same reefs regularly for 35 years. This is a reliable way to measure change on the Great Barrier Reef. One of the elements that we survey is percent coral cover. This is a simple, robust, but widely used measure of coral reef condition. Hard coral cover looks at the proportion of hard coral compared to other components such as algae, sand, and other marine creatures. Hard coral is important because it forms a three-dimensional structure that supports reef fish and all the other marine life that lives on the reef. Over longer timescales, it builds the physical structure of the reef itself. We survey coral cover using mander tows, where a snorkeler is towed around the perimeter of each reef to assess general reef condition. We compare the percent of hard coral cover on each reef to the previous year. If the number has gone down, we know that more coral has been lost than has been gained. If the number goes up, we can say that the reef is in a period of growth or recovery. It's important to note that even the healthiest of reefs won't have 100% coral cover. While coral cover is a good indication of reef condition, it isn't everything, and diversity on the reef is also important. That's why we dive deeper and undertake fixed site surveys. Our coral reef ecologists cover a smaller portion of the reef. They take photos of the reef surface so that they can undertake a more detailed analysis and better understand this amazing and complex ecosystem. Detailed information from our surveys is available publicly on the AIMS data platform and also in our annual reports. Reliable, large-scale, long-term data on how the reef is changing is essential to inform government, industry, and the wider community about Australia's tropical coral reefs.